In photography, if we're having a hard time explaining what we're doing, we create a new word that everyone who hears it knows what we're talking about. An example of this is worm's eye view. What we're saying is take the picture as close to the ground as a worm would take the photo if it had the camera. I love this view. I use the worm's eye view a lot in my photography. It gives you very unique perspectives in your photos. In this video, I thought I'd give you a few pointers on things I've learned using this view. First off, when taking these kinds of pictures, focus becomes very important. If an object is too close to the lens, your camera cannot focus on it. Also, if you let your camera have its way, it'll always make what's in the background in focus, and whatever is close, out of focus. The trick is to find out how close you can get to an object before your camera can't focus on it. Then lock the focus before taking the photo. On my camera, there's a button that does that. On other cameras, holding the shutter release button halfway down does the trick. I do lay on the ground like a worm when I'm taking these kind of shots, but sometimes there's water or mud. In those instances, I hold the camera down as low as I can to take the shot. After I've taken the shot, I look at the viewfinder to see if it's a good photo. It may take a few shots of trial and error until you get the photo that you're after. Tedious, but it does work. Last, I like to shoot in such a way so my sky is never exposed. When you use the worm's eye view, the flash on my camera works great, because the objects are close. You can get some very intense color and light when shooting in this manner. Give it a try. Keep working at it until you're proficient. It's one of those skills that gives you an abundance of great photos. Well, that's it for this video from the worm's eye view. Have fun and keep shooting.